Grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. As we begin our Advent season, we ask God's blessings upon our parish Advent wreath. Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessing upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord, forever and ever. As we prepare the way of the Lord, as we await his coming, we examine our own conscience and ask his merciful forgiveness. Lord, you are the beginning and end of our lives. Lord, have mercy. You are the Creator and Redeemer of all. Christ, have mercy. You are our great King, our Shepherd, our Priest, and our Savior. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her, the Lord our justice. The word of the Lord.
Teach me your paths, guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior, and for you I wait all the day. Sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. All the paths of the Lord are kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and his decrees. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him, and his covenant for their instruction. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that as you receive from us how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
According to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, there will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these things begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that they catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord. Israel was a defeated, conquered nation. Most of the Jews felt God had abandoned them. He forgot them. He didn't keep the covenant. He didn't keep his promise that there would always be a son of David as king to rule them. Taken into exile in Babylon, the last king of the Jews saw his sons killed before his eyes, and he was blinded and left to die there in prison. End of the dynasty of David. But then Israel heard these words of Jeremiah: "The days are coming when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land." Yes, the Lord would keep his promise. In a way that they did not know, he would send another son of David, drawn from that dynasty, through Joseph, his foster father, who was a descendant of the house of David. Jesus the Messiah would come and deliver his people from all evil. They were able to raise their heads, and in spite of all the darkness of their lives, they knew the kingdom of our God is coming again. God has not abandoned us. God has not forgotten us. So here we enter again into this season of Advent, a real challenge for us. You're being bombarded by advertising day after day, trying to get you to spend as much money as possible for all the things that seem so important, and we will leave them all behind. Yes, these are days when the advertising commercial world takes our spiritual season of Advent and makes it into a materialistic thing. Instead of being lifted up in the spirit, you will be crushed down with all these promises of material things, preoccupation with buying and selling. It's a real challenge for us to keep the real spirit of Advent. This is a time when we face the darkness of the world around us, and we look forward to that day when Jesus Christ, the light of the world, comes to us once again. Unfortunately, many people with their Christmas decorations don't know what the significance is of all those lights. I can still remember as a teenager coming out of our house with Mom and Dad to go to the midnight mass. And for the first time, the whole neighborhood was lit up. Up to that night, everything was in darkness. They then understood the meaning, the significance of those lights. Yes, we try to anticipate the coming of the Christ. And we know that that is the goal of our lives, the goal of all of human history. It is what is most important in life, and this ought to be a time when we can focus on that. What is our life all about? Where are we going? We take stock of our own lives in all honesty and recognize where we have too often blown out the light of Christ in our life and turn to sinful things. This is a time when we recognize our need for the Savior. I hope that in spite of all the things that happen these coming weeks and all the commercial pressures upon you, that you will make that effort to keep the real spirit of Advent, to remember what it is really all about. You hear Jesus in the Gospel speaking of his coming, the Son of Man, he called himself, that phrase from the book of Daniel, not as emotional as calling himself Son of David, the Messiah, no, Son of Man, coming on the clouds of heaven. But Jesus knows us. He knows how difficult it is at times for us to wait. And especially we American people, we don't like to wait for anything. We want instant coffee, instant food. We don't want to have to wait. But our God calls us to wait for the coming of his Son. And that means, as he says, beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life. Oh yes, every one of us has so many things to deal with in life that make us anxious at times, worried about this or that. And yes, at times we turn to carousing, drunkenness. We forget. We lose ourselves in the pleasures of this life and forget the pleasure that awaits us in eternal life. Jesus says, be vigilant at all times. Wake up. Remember what you are all about and what is the goal of your life. Remember, the Lord is coming to him. Are you coming to him? He comes to you, the Savior, the Redeemer, to complete his work in you, to bring you into the kingdom of eternal life and joy and peace and light. Yes, this is a time, a challenging time, for us to keep proper perspective on life and to remember the Lord is coming and we must be ready when he comes.
We renew our profession of faith in the Lord as we pray together the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess from baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Advent is a time for all of us to wake up to what is most important in life. As we prepare for the coming of Christ, we present our petitions.
Our response is, come, Lord Jesus. Advent is a time of waiting for all who believe in Jesus, that they may wake up and seek the kingdom of Christ and his way to true life and peace, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a time of hope for those who have suffered because of war, terrorism, violent crime, for those who are unemployed, homeless, and hungry, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a time of yearning that all priests and religious will remain faithful in seeking to build the kingdom, and that many more will give their lives to serve Christ and his people, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a season of preparation for the children of our parish who this week prepare for their first confession, and for all of us preparing for the holidays, that we may seek the Lord who is coming, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a time of searching for all who seek meaning in life, truth, and authentic love and community, especially those in our parish and families who have wandered away from the Lord, that all may search for and find Christ, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a time of healing for those who are ill in mind, body, or spirit, especially Frank Sullivan, Catherine Thomas, Gay Marigi, Ella Kirksey, Jim Fadina Sr., Patricia Darmanin, Stephanie Bidwell, John Williams, Kathy DeMauro, and all the sick of our parish and families, that they may find healing, strength, and peace, we pray.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Advent is a time of joy for all who have completed their advent of faith and hope, especially all the souls for whom this Mass is being offered, and for Father Cornelius Breslin, that they may see Jesus in glory and eternal joy, we pray.
Amen, Lord Jesus.
We pause to celebrate and think of our personal intentions. In confident trust, we pray.
Amen, Lord Jesus. Father, even as we face the darkness and the evil of the world around us, we have hope that the coming of your Son will bring joy and peace to us who yearn for him who is Lord forever and ever.
Please join in singing number 47, Beyond the Moon and Stars, number 47.
To rest. stars, as deep as night, so great a hunger, Lord, to see your light. The sparrow finds her home beneath your wings, so
Lord God of hosts.
through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
All your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, especially all those members of our families and friends whose names are placed before us to be remembered in prayer, and to all who are pleasing you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
In our Christian family prayer, we pray for the coming of the kingdom of our God and Savior as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. We share the sign of peace.
Say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
sing our communion hymn, number 66. Maranatha, number 66.
Rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh,
You may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in the peace and love of Christ. Have a good evening.
Please join in singing number 581, Soon and Very Soon, number 581.